Kaylin Keres, and I'm a graduate student at Eastern Illinois University, and today I'm going to talk about the safe guidelines that mothers should follow when handling their breast milk. And it's really important that mothers understand and know that these guidelines, because a baby's digestive system and immune system is vulnerable to any contamination from bacteria in the breast milk. So first I'm going to talk about general food safety guidelines that you should follow. You should always wash your hands before you pump your breast milk, and then the container that you pump your breast milk into should be cleaned with hot soapy water or in the dishwasher and dried thoroughly before the breast milk is poured in. And also, you should never add warm breast milk into frozen breast milk, because that could cause the frozen breast milk to partially thaw. We don't want that. So now, what kind of containers do you use to store breast milk in? Well, you can use hard plastic or glass containers. You can see here that I have these storage bottles that are made of hard plastic, or you can also use storage bags. Now, the storage bags should be especially designed to store human breast milk, and these are made with a thicker plastic. There's a double seal, a double zipper right here, as you can see, and these features allow the container to hold the breast milk without leaking or without the problem of tearing or just becoming a risk of any contamination in the freezer. So you really want to make sure that the plastic is designed to hold breast milk. Now, one thing I want to talk about with the plastic containers is that you should really try to purchase containers that are BPA free, and you can tell that they're BPA free because they'll say on the packaging, they'll say BPA free. And what BPA is it stands for bisphenol A. And it's a harmful chemical that can actually leak into the liquid that the container is holding, in this case breast milk, and then your baby would digest the BPA. So we don't want that. So really make sure that you try and only purchase BPA-free products. Now, next, how long can you store the breast milk for? Well, after you pump your breast milk, you can keep it at room temperature for 6 to 8 hours. The container should be sealed airtight, and it should be kept in a cool place. You can also store your breast milk in the refrigerator for up to 8 days, also sealed airtight, and it should be kept in the back of the refrigerator. Or you can store your breast milk in the freezer for 3 to 6 months, also stored airtight, and try and keep the breast milk in the back of the freezer where the temperature is kept the most constant. Finally, if you have a deep chest freezer, you can also keep your breast milk in there for up to a year. Now, before you put your breast milk into the freezer, label it with the date that you pumped the breast milk, because when you go to pull it out, you really want to use the oldest breast milk first. So by labeling it, you'll be able to know which is the oldest. Now, next I'm going to talk about the two ways that you can thaw your breast milk. Now, you can take your breast milk out of the freezer, grabbing the oldest first, and put it into the refrigerator and let it thaw overnight so it's ready to use for the next day. Or you can thaw your breast milk by running it under cold or under warm running water, or like I'm doing right here, put it into a bowl of warm water. And you just want to use your hands to massage it and break it up and thaw it, and then you can open up the container and it's ready to be poured into a bottle. Now, once you have your thawed breast milk, you can keep it in the refrigerator for up to 24 hours. But if you don't use it within that 24 hours, you need to throw it away, because you can't refreeze breast milk, and it'll spoil if you wait any longer than 24 hours. And two last things about thawing your breast milk. Never thaw it in the microwave or in boiling water on the stove, because this can destroy some of the precious nutrients in breast milk, or it could also cause hot spots in the breast milk, which would then scald your baby. So we don't want to worry about that. So really stick to the two ways of thawing your breast milk: in the refrigerator or in warm water. And finally, breast milk may separate during storage, and you could probably notice this by seeing a thin layer of cream or fat on the top. And this is no problem, it's completely normal. All you have to do is just swirl the container of the breast milk, and all the nutrients will be blended, and that'll be fine to feed to your child. So I have talked about the general food safety guidelines with handling your breast milk, the type of containers that you can use to store your breast milk in, the length and the temperature the length of time and the temperature at which you can store your breast milk in, and finally, the two ways to thaw your breast milk. And if you have any more questions or you want to find further information, please visit womenshealth.gov. Thank you.